Shireen is asking from the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Dear Master, Krishna is telling Arjun, I am time, the destroyer of all. I have come to consume the world. Even without your participation, all the warriors gathered here will die. What must I understand from the statement of Krishna, I am time? Is he not the timeless spirit? With love and gratitude, Shireen. Shireen, both. He is both. It depends on who is looking at him. If you abide in timelessness, then Krishna is just the timeless spirit. You need not even call him the timeless spirit. Then you just call him absolute timelessness. Right? Whatever there is holds its identity, its name in context of the viewer. Are you getting it? For a common man to say that God is timelessness is absurd. Why? Because the common man exists purely in time. Existing purely in time, do you even have any conception of timelessness? Is it possible? No. And even if you have a conception, it is exactly that, a concept. And timelessness cannot be a concept, right? Hence, for the mortal beings on earth, God or truth has to be time rather than timelessness. To call him timelessness is the prerogative of only the ones who have really known. Others, if they call him timeless, they are just dealing in meaningless tributes. We, as products of time, have to look for truth within time. That is the reason why we look back to a Christ. That is why we worship the saints. That is why we sit in front of a master. All of these are within time. The timeless one cannot come to help you except through his manifestation in time. Now, who is Arjun? Is he somebody who continuously abides in timelessness? That is the reason, till the time Krishna is mentioning timelessness to him, Arjun is hardly impressed. 10 chapters of the Gita are gone and Arjun is still dithering, very uncertain. Then in the 11th chapter, Krishna reveals to him something that would finally convince him. And what does he reveal to him? His formless nature, his timeless nature, his nameless nature, his dimensionless nature. Is that what is revealed to Arjun? No. On the contrary, Krishna reveals to Arjun the totality of time that Krishna stands for. Krishna reveals to Arjun the magnificence of all beings encompassed in all space. And then Arjun says, now it's okay. I understand. Yes. 10 chapters could not make that kind of a mark on Arjun, which this demonstration within time and space did. Remember that it is a demonstration. The student is not getting convinced by mere theoretical elucidation. So what has the teacher done? Teacher has finally given him a practical proof. A practical and sensual proof. Look, Arjun. See, hear, smell. It's a sensory proof. And that is what all beings on the earth need. That is what all students need. And saints have repeatedly said, they have said, the formless Brahm is of very little use to us. We need a teacher in name, in body, available to us in the physical sense. Of what use is Brahma? Will Brahma come to teach me? I need somebody who is what Krishna is to Arjun. Both a friend and a guide. That's the relationship between Krishna and Arjun, right? And now you know why Arjun was the only one who could comprehend the Gita. He was the only one who was chosen to receive the Gita. Because he had, first of all, a personal relationship with Krishna. With Brahma, you cannot have a personal relationship, or can you? With God the Father sitting in the heavens, you cannot have a personal relationship. And that is the reason he had to send his son down, so that you can have a personal relationship. Don't you wonder? If God is sufficient, why did he have to send his son down to the earth, and that too to all the buggers who chased him and almost executed him? Because when it comes to man, even God is helpless. Man is something of a superstar. God might be omnipresent. Man says, who? Where is he? Look at man's guts. Look at his defiance. Look at his petulance. He can be insubordinate even to the omnipresent. He says, where is God? Don't you say that. Where is God? So God says, I will not be able to beat this rock star. He says, where is God? So finally he has to send down, or rather appear in a way that is similar to that of man. And therefore Krishna must appear as a product of time in front of Arjun. Otherwise Arjun will not listen. Eleventh chapter is a great proof and a great example in dialectics. Mere words do not convince a student. The student is just incapable. Even Krishna had to practically demonstrate. The trouble with the nameless, formless, absolute one is that he cannot come down to demonstrate anything to you. So he has to assume a form and a shape in time. Those shapes you will not need when you move into timelessness. But as long as you are within time, you require someone within time. You understand? Within being within time, what is it to be within time? To be born and to die. You require someone who will be born just as you are born. You require someone who will die just as you will die. You require someone who has a body just as you have. You require someone who has gone through the experiences of life just as you go through. You need someone who suffers just as you do. You need someone who has all the tendencies as you have. Only then can there be some communication. Only then will learning be possible for you. Right? Getting it?